I used to believe that we must choose between science and reason on one hand, and spirituality on the other, in how we lead our lives. Now I consider this is a false choice. We can recover the sense of sacredness not just in science, but in perhaps every area of life. Dr. Larry Doocy from Reinventing Medicine. Welcome to Science and Spirituality on Supreme Master Television. Many of us pray in various ways when facing serious illness or injury. Even more of us pray as sincerely as we can when our loved ones encounter major health issues in life. But does prayer actually help in healing?
There are easily a couple dozen major studies in humans looking at the ability of prayer, or what researchers usually call healing intentions, to make a difference in somebody else's clinical course, even though they are unaware that this is being done. The landmark study was done at the University of California, San Francisco School of Medicine, published in 1988, looking at the effects of prayer to make a difference in patients in the coronary care unit. Those patients who were prayed for, unknown to them, had a better clinical course in many different areas than people in the so-called control group who were not intentionally prayed for. Those studies have been refined, improved over the years. We see studies now in not just heart disease, but in severe conditions such as advanced AIDS. We see studies, interestingly, not just in people, but in, for example, animals and the physiology of plants and enzyme systems, even biochemical reactions in test tubes seem to respond to people's thoughts and intentions.
Dr. Larry Doocy, distinguished physician and international lecturer, is the author of several critically acclaimed titles, including Reinventing Medicine, Healing Words, The Power of Prayer and the Practice of Medicine. Be careful what you pray for, you just might get it. Recovering the Soul, A Scientific and Spiritual Search. And in recent years, The Extraordinary Healing Power of Ordinary Things. Dr. Larry Doocy has appeared on widely popular American television shows such as Oprah and on leading U.S. television channels such as CNN and The Learning Channel.
The new part of this is the evidence, the scientific studies, which illustrate that when you look at this, that's actually what happens when you do a what we call double-blind control test. You can show that something is happening at a distance. You can look at growth rates, or you can look at the rate of germination of seeds, even, which is a common methodology. And if you perform statistical analyses of these studies, you show, I think, very compellingly that something real is happening. And you can refine these human studies. You can look at, for instance, different types of cells, connective tissue cells, the cells in the body that create bone, and the types of cells that produce antibodies and are connected with inflammatory responses, and look at specific metabolism in these cells, and you can show that you can perk them up and modify their metabolic activity.
How do you define prayer in, you know, used with these studies, and is there a certain kind of prayer that's being used? Are there different kinds of...
I think we can say beyond a doubt now that no religion seems to have cornered the market on prayer. Some of these studies had looked at people who may pray to the universe or offer a general supplication, may the best thing happen in this situation for this person. You can't show any difference in the effects of these different methodologies. I simply say prayer is communication with the absolute, and invite people to define what form this communication may take. And so we could ask, what is it that works? What has to be present for these things to work? I think that there's a little four-letter word that says more than anything. It's love.
When we return, we will hear Dr. Larry Doocy speak on the three eras of Western medicine. You're watching Science and Spirituality on Supreme Master Television.
a living creature. It's a being, just like us. Exactly. You understand? It's just a little more gifted with intuition and sharper faculty. You understand? Sometimes when you look into their eyes, my God, you feel the message coming. They're equal. Just like different kind of trees, but they're all trees. Different kind of beings, they're all beings. Just different, understand? Just like we Chinese, you American. He's a parrot, we're human.
In the DVD, The Divine Intelligence of Animals, Supreme Master Ching Hai shares her experience of adopting and caring for animals, such as parrots and dogs, during a gathering with spiritual practitioners in Florida, USA. Her boundless love and meticulous observations remind us to love our animal friends and give us a better understanding of animal spirituality and loyalty. Through Supreme Master Ching Hai's words, we find that the sentience of animals is no less than that of humans, who are the most spiritual beings among all God's creatures. Discover the true nature of our animal friends. Get the DVD, The Divine Intelligence of Animals, by visiting us online at www.smchbooks.com.
Welcome back to today's show entitled Why Prayer is Scientific, Dr. Larry Doce on Medicine and Spirituality. Many recent studies have established evidence for the power of prayer. According to Dr. Larry Doce, past executive editor of the peer-reviewed journal Alternative Therapies in Health and Medicine, prayers work because of love.
We can call it compassion or deep caring. Old physicians in our culture used to call it bedside manner. That captured love, devotion, compassion. But if you take away love, or really deep connectedness between the healer and the patient, these studies don't work very well. Sometimes they fall flat.
You speak about era one, era two, and era three medicine. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
I came up with this terminology in one of my early books to try to make sense of all of the new therapies that were surfacing, beginning really back in the 70s. And so era one medicine is conventional scientific type medicine, the use of drugs, surgical procedures, and so on. I call it mechanical medicine because that's pretty much what it looks like. It was based upon the old mechanical idea of how the world operates. There was no place for mind or consciousness or healing in era one medicine. Beginning in the post-World War II time period, however, something else began to change. This was the advent of what I call Era 2, or mind-body medicine. We didn't call it mind-body medicine then. We called it psychosomatic disease. But the new idea was this, that your thoughts and emotions and attitudes and feelings might influence your own body. And so we had a variety of diseases which seemed to illustrate this. Tension headaches, ulcerations of the stomach and duodenum, high blood pressure, and so on, seemed to illustrate that the mind could affect the body. Now, this seems very basic and really primitive now, but in those days, this was radical new stuff.
Now, that's where beliefs come into play?
Exactly.
And
for your own physiology.
Yes.
Your beliefs affect you.
Yeah.
Now, era three is the era which I call non-local medicine, which we're living into currently. This is where spirituality comes in prayer and so on. This is the idea that your mind may not be able to affect just your body, but it can affect possibly the body of someone else out there at a distance.
Healing Words, Dr. Larry Doocy's fourth book, which was based on his research at Princeton University, presents scientific evidence that prayer can influence the outcome of random physical events even at a great distance. This and other research reveal, as Dr. Doocy puts it, that consciousness is partially free of human body and the constraints of time and space.
There's some aspect of our consciousness that operates freely in space and time. We can manifest our intentions at a distance, as we see in these studies. If you follow the logic here, there seems to be some part of our consciousness, some basic element of who we are, that's what I call non-local or infinite in time. If that's so, then some aspect of our consciousness is immortal.
It just sounds like you define the soul.
Well, I have defined the soul. Actually, I wrote a book once called Recovering the Soul, which was about this very idea. We're stuck with immortality. I mean, we just might as well get used to it. It's part of who we are. So, you know, if we get sick and die and the wheels come off our health, we'll just have to settle for immortality. So I think we need to lighten up on ourselves. We do not create all of our reality 100%. How do we know that? Well, look at these healing studies. Prayer has an effect on your physical reality if you're a subject in one of these experiments. So what this means is that I can partially create your reality through my compassionate prayers for you. You can do the same to me. So we get to the point where we say, reality is a mutual creation between all of us. You can influence my reality through intentions, and I can influence yours. These studies clearly show that. And so far, we just can't specify that one technique beats all the others. Again, I think this is a terrific implication because it says we have to look into our heart and find the method that is most genuine and authentic for us. There isn't any formula here.
Dr. Larry Doocy has spoken at prestigious medical institutions including Harvard, Johns Hopkins, Cornell, and the Mayo Clinic. He notices that medical schools are recognizing the role of spirituality and prayer in the treatments of patients.
The good news is that many of the medical schools are beginning to introduce this kind of information in the curriculum of the medical school. When I wrote this book, Healing Words, in 1993, only three of these 125 medical schools had any sort of coursework looking at the connection between spirituality and health. Currently, over 90 schools have formal coursework exploring this data. This is a landmark event.
Yeah, wow.
This is just huge.
Amazing.
So we'll see what difference it makes down the line. But my hunch is that this is going to revolutionize our notions about death and immortality and the goals of medicine.
Thank you for being with us for this episode of Science and Spirituality. Please join us next week for part two with Dr. Larry Doocy, who will speak about health and happiness and the sacredness of the everyday. Coming up next on Supreme Master Television is Words of Wisdom, right after Noteworthy News. May the light of hope and love fill our world.